Howdy, howdy. I haven't done one of these in a really long time. And I'm using my phone. That's why my head's cut off again. Anyway, normal drill. Here we go. Impressionistic and romantic sounds. This is a Ted Green page from one of the more recent uploads from the website. Beautiful set of chords. Nothing here is difficult. Just a bunch of C6s, E6s, and A flat 6s in sequence. Two each. That's motion in major thirds, which is actually a really cool sound. Some of you may know that that's the kind of John Coltrane secret chord progression thing. Motion in major thirds, major chords moving in major thirds. Giant Steps does that as far as its overall key changes. G, E flat, and G, B, and E flat in that tune. Anyway, this could be used as an ending or an intro or just a really pretty set of chords. I have a shimmer reverb effect going on a little bit that you probably can hear just to give it a little extra back end sauce. I did it, I think, two different ways up at the top there. I just played the grips by themselves and then I arpeggiated them. You could do it any way you want to. I'll do it slow now. So the sequence is going to be two C6s, two E6s, two A-flat 6s, and then it's going to repeat an octave higher. None of the grips are hard, as I said, and it's the same set of notes or intervals, just repeated over and over again in three different octaves. So here's the lower octave, C6, C6, which also looks like an A minor 7th chord. E6, another E6, A-flat 6, looks just like an F minor 7th, right? Where am I at? C6 again, C6, E6, E6, A-flat 6, A-flat 6. C6, 9. I suppose we could end it like this. Keep the 6th happening. Let's see what that sounds like. Cool. Could major end major 7th. All kinds of ways. So let's go slower again, just so you can see what I'm doing here. Let's see, I position myself. Here we go. Whoops, stop. So that move is the same on the lower set of four strings. Change hand positions and string sets. We're in the middle here. We could do that this way to keep it consistent. Then, same thing again. I like ending on that C6 line. If you were sitting in a lesson with Ted and he showed you this, he would say, be able to play it all four notes at the same time, and also be able to arpeggiate it either straight ascending or descending. Split the difference, and I'm going to do low note, high note, and then descend. So strings 6, 3, 4, 5. Major seventh at the end there that time. Like I said, intro, ending, you could, let's just put it in context, at the end of a standard. It's a little bit long of a sequence, so I'm going to put it at the end of, oh, let's do the last A section of Satin Doll. It's almost going to be as long as half that A section, so I'll do it, but and then I'll cut it in half. I'll start maybe over here. Just for an end. So last A section of Doll. Let's take the shimmer off. Be a little bit more era conscious, although I am playing a jazz master. Cool, you know, when you get it, you get the technique under your hands, you can play it rather quickly, or we can just do the last part of it. There we go, nice short. We could use it as an intro. Let's see. Idea. Mix, match, great bunch of voicings for sixth chords. Sounds really pretty. It's also good to get that grip down. Now, if you want to do some extra credit here, this is a perfect opportunity to work on your one finger tip per two adjacent strings, which is a George Van Epps TED thing. So that first chord, that C6 right here, you could do it like this. I don't. This guitar has a really wide neck. It's a lot easier on my 335. I can't do it. Right? I'll admit it right now. I was never very good at this. Little easier on the fifth and fourth string. Whoops. So you can use it to practice that. Anyway, I hope you like this lesson. If I can find it at the Ted Green website, I will put a link to it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.